So the question then becomes, can the owners always make sure that the managers listen to them and act in the best interest of the company? So this is an example of what is known in economics as the principal agent problems. Now, one of the features of the complex modern society is that people, often the principals, have to employ other people who are the agents to carry out their wishes. Now, if you want to go on a holiday, you go to a travel agent to sort out the arrangements rather than do it all yourself because, for example, if you are going to Italy, you don't even know Italian. So it's very difficult to plan. So it's the same with if you want to buy a house. It's more convenient to go to an estate agent. The point is that these agents have specialized knowledge and it can save you time. It can save the principal a lot of time and effort. So this is just one of the examples of the benefits of specialization and division of labor. Now it's the same with firms. A great deal of time and effort can be saved if firms employ people with specialist knowledge and skills to carry out specific tasks. And sometimes they employ consultants to give them advice and they engage the services of special firms, such as an advertising agency. And employees, it's the same thing. They can be seen as agents of the employer. So in the case of workers, they can be seen as agents of the management. Junior managements are the agents of senior management. Senior managements are the agents of directors. And those are themselves the agent of the shareholders. So in large firms, there's often a complex chain of principal-agent relationships. But these relationships have an inherent danger for the principal because there's asymmetric information. One guy knows more than the other. The agent knows more about the situation than the principal. In fact, this is part of the reason why the principal employs the agent in the first place. The guy who plans your holiday definitely knows more about the holiday location than you, or else why would you ask him to plan your holiday? But the danger is that the agent may not act in the principal's best interest and may not be, and he may be able to get away with it because, like I said, you don't know Italian, you don't know Italy at all. The holiday agent can just scam you to accept, let's say, a lousier venue, and the estate agent may be able to convince you that you can only sell your house at a lower price and that you can only buy a house maybe at a higher price. In firms too, agents frequently do not act in the best interests of the principals. For example, workers may be able to get away with not working very hard and preferring instead a quiet life. Same thing given the divorce of ownership between the managers of the firm and the owners, which are the shareholders of the firm. They may pursue goals quite differently from that of the shareholders, which are the principals. They may just slack off, or in economics, cause what we call X inefficiency.